All right, so like from where we just stopped is we are able to create the application and we've added a preview to it, and this is what it looks like right now. Personally, I don't like the default one, so let's just do a little bit of change. So we'll go to Bootswatch. Bootswatch is free Bootstrap themes, and there's one I really like. Lumen. Lumen is cool. So let's take Lumen. All I just need to do is download the Bootstrap min.css. Let me download the Bootstrap CSS proper. So copy that. Come to
Contents Bootstrap CSS.
Let me create a new style sheet. Let's call this Lumen Bootstrap.css. Okay. So here, Control A, Control V, save. Right. So now that that's done, all I just need to do now is come to my
Layouts,
layout file.
reference the new scripts.
Lumen. That's Lumen Bootstrap CSS. Save that. Come back here. Refresh. Okay, at least we have something. So, the thing we need to care about now is, okay, why is this one saying inverse? I think we need to remove that inverse. That's what's causing the problem. So that should be navbar in default. Okay, all right.
Yes.
So we have something that is, that closely looks like an application. So the next step we need to do now is what? We need to, I need to just put a authorized attribute just to see what will happen.
In the home
This is
controller.
Yes, in the home controller. This is crucial, and you will find out why in a moment. So let's build and let's refresh this page. Okay. Bam.
Yes,
You see this?
exactly.
This return 401 not authorized. The reason you are seeing this 401 not authorized is because the MVC pipeline returned 401, then IIS now say, oh, okay, it's a 401
One.
and now generated this page. So this page is
Exactly.
actually from IIS,
Yes.
which is a managed pipeline request handler, execute request handler, MVC handler.
Exactly.
That's where this is coming
Yeah.
from. All right, now that we've established that, the next question we now need to do is what? We now need to add the Owing middleware.
Okay.
The own middleware pipeline. All right. So what we'll do is we need to add Microsoft.owin.security.cookies. So you will see that in a moment.
We're adding that from NuGet's
Yeah, so we say
platform.
install package Microsoft.owin.security.cookies. Okay, this one allows you to do authentication
Authentication.
using cookies essentially. That's all it is. It adds a few NuGet packages onto itself, but the let's look at the NuGet packages. These are the NuGet packages, but ultimately, what we care about here is security, cookies, and so on and so forth. What we care about is the ability to handle, so
Authentication and
authentication.
authorization.
Yes. So when we come here, we say app the use cookie authentication. It will now ask you to provide some options. Okay. So the options you say new cookie authentication options. And let us see the authentication mode should be what? Active. I don't think I need to specify that. I just need to log in path. Log in path is where it should take you to if it's
Okay.
this thing. Hold on, let me pause. All right, so like I was saying, you have your login path here.
Okay.
This login path, remember, when I did it earlier, it went through and IIS returned an error. In other words, the error just flew through the MVC pipeline.
Exactly.
MVC did not handle it.
Exactly.
And IIS had to now return a 403 error.
Exactly.
Okay. But by adding this middleware, we're now intercepting
those requests
and responses.
Yeah.
So this is where we now specify the login path. So let the login path be /account/login.
Okay.
There are so many distance you could put here. But for now, let's just leave it this one.
Okay,
so I think you have to supply a path string object, which we've done, and that now tells us that once a login fails, just redirect them to this.
Yes.
Okay. Let me make it simpler. Let me come here and create a function. I think I should just extract it as a method. So Visual Studio Control RM allows you to extract it as a method. So let's call this method what's configure authentication. Right? Configure auth makes sense. So once we've done that, we now have the cookie authentication here all set up. Now let's see the effect of this minor change we've made. Okay. Now the effect is when we already control F5. So when I build control shift B, I can now come here and refresh. And now you see what will happen. Let me refresh it again. Aha. Did you see what just happened? It redirected to /account/login.
Yes, but there's no view page.
There's no view page for it to display.
But it's redirecting to where we want it to go.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
This dance we've done is authorization. Authorization is who can access what.
Exactly.
That's all.
Exactly.
So authorization all boils down to what? Adding the OAuth middleware, configuring using cookie authentication, configuring the login path, and that is all. That is all. No, there is no, all other gymnastics are just, you know, smokes and mirrors. Yeah, they're just extras. This is the main deal. All right, so let's make it even more fleshed out. Let's go and create our account controller. Come here, call it account, add that, and in my account controller I want to call have a login page, so call this login.
Okay, we're also going to add the authorize attribute.
No, we wouldn't. Because if we did, then what would happen is when it redirects them to login will redirect them back to login and to cause it. Yeah. So
just to clarify that.
Yeah. So what we now need to do is I don't have time. So let me just quickly collect Bootstrap. I think Bootstrap has some templates here. Just collect login page for Bootstrap. So the snippets for Bootstrap are here. Interesting. The Bootstrap snippets are not here. Anywho, nothing spoiled. Let's go to
Bootstrap.
Yes, let's go to get Bootstrap. Cost components, the CSS forms. Yeah, I prefer the horizontal one. So just copy the whole thing. Paste it here like this. We save. I should be able to share. I need to just build again.
Yes.
And after that I should just come here and refresh. Okay.
Yes.
So the login page is ready. So I'm going to create admin@gmail, password. It's working. So now what now happens is anytime you try to go to index page, it will always redirect you to login, which is what we want. Alright. The next step. I think the next step we need to do now is we've done authorization.
Mm-hmm.
What is lacking is authentication. So authentication is where we have the account login. Let's go